Hello everybody, welcome back. So this is episode 14 of my welcome back everybody. This is episode 14 of BAME's Monster Adventure, and I am going to continue working with Rotarycraft today. As I was mentioning in the last episode, we're wanting to get some hydrokinetic engines up and running, and we're going to get that up and running now. This first machine here, dynamometer, allows you to monitor the inputs and outputs from machines, and I'm just going to use that. I'm going to create 8 hydrokinetic engines. Now, although they're static down here, you can't shift click out of that machine for some reason. Right. So I've added some water coming down into here. And I've also added that liquid duct will connect into, well, it's running most of the way up. To connect into my lubricant system. And the hydrokinetic engines won't run until they're provided with lubricant. Now this is where we're going to place them. What needs to be running down that side of them if you're placing them this way? They only turn one direction, so just something to be made aware of. And also, it seems like you need a bit of water going underneath them like this, or... Just thinking, you might not need that water underneath, but it seemed to help me. I couldn't have these down any lower. I think you need space around them as well. This seems to give them enough space. I might need to knock out these blocks at the back here. Yeah, I can't place them down right. I'm just going to knock that out and see if that helps. Yeah, there we go. Now, I might not have left myself enough space here. These will do damage to you. Depends if I ever need to go back there. I might just leave it like that. Little neat enough. Okay. Then we'll just add a dynamometer. Turn it round. I think that's the right way. Okay, I need to tweak the lubricant hose up here to get it connecting properly. Oh, you can see that. We're starting to fill up the lubricant drum, which means that this gear here is full of lubricant, so we're making more than we're using. That's handy enough. Oops. It was just up here I needed to be. So I think it's just this bit here I hadn't connected in. There we go. Okay, there we go. They're getting lubricant pumped into them now. That's not facing the right way. Okay, so we can see here we're getting 4 million watts, or megawatts, 131,000 newton meters, and 32 rads. Rads radian per second. That meant it's revolving. Or so what we want to do is move this power to the top. Just keeping an eye on these numbers here. We could use shafts all the way up. Something to bear in mind is that we've got more, so we've almost got double this amount of newton meters going out at the moment, not that amount of rads. So I think we could maybe gear this stuff down towards steel or stone to use shafts all the way up. The important thing to notice here is that this torque is higher than this diamond value here, so that means the first gear we need to convert this value down will have to be bedrock. I'm not actually going to use shafts all the way up. What I'm going to use is a belt hub. So this stretches a belt between two of these belt hubs, the bottom of the top. Have a look here, belt can only transmit so much power without slipping, can only carry at maximum 8192 newton meters of torque at 8192 rads. Pulling up the calculator. Okay, so that's 16, so we need to take the torque down by 16 to get it to 8192, and then 16 times 32, it's only 512 rads. Okay, here's the bedrock breaker, and then here's the bevel gear. That gets us four of them. That's handy enough. And as I said, you don't to putting the power through a bevel gear. You could worm your way all the way up with bevel gears. You know, they're pretty cheap to make, and they don't need lubricant, and they won't break no matter what shaft load you put through them. So you could just worm your way up with those, but I don't think that's what the mod maker wanted. Okay, so you can see that there's various colours on various sides. That'd be the yellow side there. Sometimes it's a little bit... Oh, that's that paddle doing damage to me. Sometimes it's difficult to see, but that's black is that input side there. And it's light blue is down that way. So black is input and output is light blue. Right, so there you see there's power going down. Right, let's start breaking some bedrock. It's not facing the right way. Okay, there we go. So it's starting to work away. It's going to take a long time. I'll be back with you when it's done. It won't break out the very bottom level of layer of bedrock, so you don't need to worry about creating holes in your wall or holes in your floor of your world. We can't see much on that, it doesn't have an interface, but if we have a look in here, so it'll grind out four bits of bedrock. So you can see that we have about eight times the power required, so you could run this off one sole. One of these hydrokinetic engines required torque is 8192, which was the amount we want to get it down. So you could speed it up by 16 times, but by the time we've sped it up 16 times, we'll have got all the gears we need to transfer it back upstairs. Let's transfer the power back upstairs. We might want to get some more bedrock while we're here though, and the machine's operational speed goes up as the input speed does. So we'd want to get this torque down to 8k through gears, and then we can the speed will be faster and we'll start to mine a bit faster. Anyway, this is just going to slowly work away. and I'll be back with you later. Okay, this has been running for a little while. You see, it's created a little hole down there. It's definitely digging up the bedrock. If we right click on it, you get the bedrock dust out of the machine. Oh, welcome back, guys. Right, so don't have it still breaking bedrock. I've moved around another one there. These still got lubricant in them, but I am getting concerned about the lubricant levels. We've come back up to the first level now. We've run out of canola seeds here. So I've switched this off so I don't damage that until we get a canola farm up and running. So that's what I'm getting on with right now. I've created myself three other steam engines and we're going to use these fans to farm the canola seeds. It doesn't seem to connect to the MFR machines, and the MFR machines don't seem to harvest the canola seeds. So we'll use the Rotarycraft system. And I'm going to use something new for me, an item collector. Let's see how that works. I could use... So these fans push the canola seeds over. Like I said, I had run out of these, but I found this watering cannon extra utilities, and I was able to... Well, I found a chest with canola seeds in them, and then I was able to speed up the growth of the canola seeds with this watering can, which is kind of a handy thing. Okay, so I could use hoppers down here. What I'm actually going to use is this. So anything that drops should hopefully get placed in here, but we'll keep an eye on it. Okay, so we've brought water down now here, and I've had to bring that out here because we've got the sludge that we're not doing anything with coming from the harvesters. These sludge, we'll do something with it in the future, but because of that, I've brought my water pipe out one block there. And I've set up an area down here for farming. They're all facing the wrong way. So these fans should start working. Yep, there's the first fan up and running. Let's try to get out of the way of it. So that's pushed one down that way, did it? Yes, they're all getting pushed over the side, I think. Oh no, maybe they're all going in there. Well, maybe it's working fine. Just make sure there's none down here. Ah, seems to be working okay. That's good news, so we've got canola farm up and running. And these engines... That one's full of water. That one's full of water. It's getting full. Yeah, that seems all fine. Okay, well, that's handy. So I'm gonna run Miami network over to here so that we're importing those canola seeds. And we'll be back up and running with that. I forgot to mention, these steam engines, they're more powerful than these fans need, so that's why we're getting such a long range on them. So, and I also wanted to make this so that it was, I didn't need to be involved with it or worry about bringing the oil across or lubricant across. So these are just self-contained systems, or it's a self-contained system, and we don't need to worry about it, it'll just run now. Okay, so I've used the bedrock breaker to break down a 4x3 size blocks, 3 depth and 4 across, so I think we've got enough bedrock dust to create the gear we needed, which was a 16 gear unit. It's already done, right, good. How much bedrock dust do we have left over? 20 and quite a few extra bits and pieces that I'm not sure why it created. I think we had a bug. Okay, so we need a mount for this. Now the bedrock gears do not need lubricant. Okay, so let's go back down here now. So we're wanting to reduce the torque and increase the speed, so let's check this. That's torque, so let's shift click on that. And let's put up our dynamometer here and check it out. So 8k torque at a speed of 512 rads. If you have a look at a book, the reason why I wanted to do all that was I wanted to transmit the power up with a belt drive, and these operate up to 8k of torque and 8k rads, so we're within those limits to allow us to use the belt drive to get the power upstairs from this. Oh, welcome back everybody. So we have have been killing a few cows, so we've got enough belts, and I'm going to use 4 belt hubs for this. Okay, so I'm going to have one belt, or I've moved all my machines downstairs, so the blast furnace has been moved down as well, so this is going to be a Rotarycraft room now. I think previously I was planning to do ICT power generation in here as well, but we're not going to do that. I'll use that room up there for IC2, and this room is just Rotarycraft now. Okay, that's not facing the right direction. When it faces that way, I'm just going to move the power from right down there, is where the belt drive is going to come up. I'm just going to change the direction of that to this way. I think probably shift right click on that. Okay, so that should be good. Okay, so there's the belt in place for that one. Now the maximum height, or the maximum distance you can connect these over is 64 blocks. Okay, we're gonna right click on that now, that's going to be an output. Just right click on that. I'm just going to come down here. I'm going to remove my power monitor from here. I'll take that back upstairs. So we can see that turning, and what we're wanting to see is the same values that we saw downstairs, so that we're not losing anything. So that was exactly what we wanted to see. Okay, next up, the whole purpose of all this is to run an extractor, and the way I'm wanting to run the extractor is without any I'm wanting to pass all these requirements without having to play around with the power. And that's why we've got the eight hydrokinetic engines, because eight's enough to get exactly what we want. So if we have a look at the requirements. So the speed is too slow, but the torque is too high. Now if we reduce the torque or increase the speed by 16, that's going to get us to meet the requirements. Okay, let's take that back. We'll check it out again in a second. So we're going to place the 16 times gearbox there. Is that the wrong way around? Right, that's the right way around. Now, is it speed or torque it's on? Right, it's on torque, so let's speed it up. Now if we connect the dynamometer. So we're running at 8,000 revolutions per second at 512 newton meters of torque, which if we check the extractor, and we're well over the power requirements. So 512 newton meters of torque on that one, and 8k rads. So that's going to be able to run an extractor without having to worry about switching up the power at all. Just didn't mean to drop that. Let's take that back now. Now the extractor's got input from the bottom for the shafts, so we need to use a bevel gear here. And this bevel gear looks like it's yellow input and maybe blue output. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, so I'm going to get a grinder, I'll be right back with you. Okay, here's our extractor. Now these were all collected with my silk touch pickaxe as I was mining downstairs. Now there's a few things in here to notice. One is, if we start mining, and we will want to start mining with silk touch on our quarry, and we'll be doing that probably next episode, all this cobblestone is not going to come out in this form. It's going to be smooth, so we need to change up all that. Another thing to notice is we're going to be getting things out in what's the difference between those? Why? Okay, so our ore generation is a bit strange, but anyway, everything's going to go through the grinder. So let's take down the iron ore. So we've got the power, speed and torque all set for the required levels. Now this water may or may not be coming in at the right place. Let's see what happens if let's swap this bit out here for a precision export bus. I'm going to have to change around a lot of this stuff, because this has only got eight items. Let's bring the iron ore in that way. Okay, so that's not doing anything at the moment. Let's just place our iron ore back in here. Okay, it's exported it and it is running. Let's just make sure it gets through all four stages fine. Okay, well, that's running fine, so I'll be right back with you. Okay, so that the extractor finished running. And if we have a look at flakes, we've got 146 flakes out from the 27 iron ore I put in. So that's going to create 146 iron bars. And what I'm going to do... Oh. That's a little bit odd. Anyway, we can remove the iron ore from that machine. Get it to start processing iron ore flakes. I'll need to check what that was previously. But it looks like it's a change. It'll be a change since upgrading to 1.10. But there's a flakes coming in. And there's... That's how we're creating the iron ore now. Okay, well, I think that's a good time to call it an end to the episode. So thank you all for watching, and I shall see you next time.